Hello everyone, welcome all. This is Mohan Raghavan. In this video series, we are going to learn Java programming language. The reason why we want to learn the Java language, the reason might be different for everyone. For example, you may be the fresher to learn the Java language as the first programming language, or you may be the QA automation guy who wants to do automation by using the Java. So that may be the reason. Or let's say you want to move on to Android development, so that you want to learn the Java as the prerequisite. Or let's say you want to do some activity in your project which has the Java as ecosystem, so that you want to learn the Java language. Or let's say simply you can say you know already some language, you want to add up one more language in your batch. So for that reason, you might be learning the Java language. Reason might be anything, but we are going to learn Java in this series. So in this video, we are going to see what is the introduction or general description about the Java and how to install Java in your system. A formal definition, you can consider Java is an object-oriented, class-based, concurrent, secured, and general-purpose computer programming language. Java is a programming language and a platform. So this is the point to be noted. You can use a Java as a programming language, or you can use a simple Java JRE in your system just for the platform for other application which was developed in the Java. Java is a high-level, robust, object-oriented, and secure programming language. So this is a formal definition. Moving on to the installing the Java, we will be going to the official website, Java SE. So here you can see oracle.com java technologies / java SE-JDK16-downloads.html. Or you can do simple Google search for Java 16, the latest version as per today, and you can install that. Once you move to the official website, you can see the different SDK available here. Sorry, JDK. Here you can see Windows 64, and you can just installer, so you can just download this one and click this and download. While it downloads, you need to make sure that you don't have already Java installed in your system. If you have already Java in your system, you just need to upgrade if required. So let's go to the command terminal. So java-version, if you see the error message like Java is not recognized command, that means that probably you don't have Java in your system. So that means that we are going to install from the scratch. So probably you have already downloaded. So let's go to the folder and click this. So you need to have the administrator access. So just run it. So it will have the simple navigation. So next, and it is going to install in C program files Java JDK 16.0.1. So this is the path you need to remember in case if you want to add the path variable in system variable. Or if you are going to change anything, you need to make sure that you know where it has been installed. Now we have successfully installed the Java. So just go to the same PC C drive, and it should be program files and Java. You can see JDK, and this is the path. Here you can see there are different already Java executables are available. In that, Java C and Java are available. So in simple, if you want to compile the program, so you need to give the your Java input program. Let's say it can be anything. In this state, we can consider like we have some Java program we want to compile and we want to run it. So your input will be your Java program, which will be the input for this Java program. Again, Java is the, here if you see the command line, you might be thinking like this is the keyword or let's say the command line terminal, some commands, right? But however, it's not. It is again another program. So that means that Java is the program, it needs the input, like online arguments or let's say the command line arguments. So that argument will be your input program. So in simple, you will type Java C and your input file, then it will compile and it will give the executable file, right? So if you type Java in your command line, so you want to know, or let's say the system has to know that where the Java program is available. So if you type simply Java in that particular path, for example, let's open the command terminal here again. So in this folder, you don't have the Java. For example, let's go to the same folder here. So again, C, users. So here you can see there is no program called Java. So when you type Java here, so it will not find it in that particular path. The one way is like you can directly go to the path where we have seen just now. For example, here C, program files, and let's say Java and JDK and bin. Here you can get it, the Java program. So from here, if you open the command terminal, and if you run the Java programs, it will run. Because if you type Java here, now it will tell and it knows where it is resides because you are in the correct path. So you can see what is the Java available options. Let's say if I want to just type Java hyphen version. So it gives the 16 version. But every time you cannot go to this folder and you cannot run the program because you will be creating the projects in the different location. So for that reason, we need to make some variable or we need to make the cmdip command line. Just to understand Java, whenever I type Java, it has to go to this path. It has to pick up the Java executable and it has to give our input. Our input indicates our, let's say, our program. So for that reason, we need to set up some variable. That variable is nothing but path variable. In order to install the Java, you need the admin access. In the same way, in order to make the path variable, let's say if you want to edit the path variable, you need to have the admin access. So just go to the Windows and search for system variable. Edit the system environment variables. And here you click on the environment variables. And here you will have two options, user variables and system variables. So generally user variables, if you log in with your credentials, then it will be available only for your case, the path variable, whatever you are setting. But if you want to make it as a global or system level, you want to edit in the system variables. So let me edit in the system variables. So path, you can see here. So what are the different paths you have? So here you can just remove this one. So Java path is already there. So you don't want that one. So you can delete it. Now we are going to add the new path, which we have already here. So let me copy this. And new, just copy it here. Sorry, this is not the one. Okay, it is not coming. I think we already opened. So that may be the reason. Let me open again. C, program files, Java, JDK, bin. Okay, fine, we are getting. Now just edit it. So some people might be using the variables for the Java home, but as of now, just to install the Java, we will install the same exact path, C, program files, Java, JDK, and bin folder, and okay. So now you can see in the path variable, if you type any command in the command line, it will try to search in this path. So let's say it will search in the system32, it will not find, so it will go to the next level and so on. For example, let's say here you can see the Node.js. For example, if I type node in the command line terminal, so what will happen is it will check in all the path, but it will find in the Node.js folder, it will execute from there. The same way, if I type Java or Java C, it will look in all these files, let's say all these folders, and it will find it in this folder and it will execute from there. So let me confirm this one, click on OK and apply everywhere and just close all the things. And let me close this one as well and close this one. Now go to the command line again, cmd. Now you can clearly see I'm in the user level folder. So I don't have any Java file in that location that we have already seen. Now if I type Java hyphen version, so here it is displaying the 16.01. So which means that now I can execute the Java programs at any folder level because I have set up the path variable. So this is all about installing the Java and setting up the path variable. So now we have the Java in our system and we have set up the path variable as well. So this is all about this video. So thanks all. Thanks for watching and have a great day.